In this TED Talk style, we are going to explore the different ways in which we can pursue a more sustainable living at home. Today, we are going to talk about Smart Home 2.0, how to become a net zero citizen. What does it mean? It means how smart tech can help us really have and be more sustainable at home. I'm your host today, I'm Joanne Gieg, and I'm in charge of communications for the residential market at Schneider. And I'm very excited to be joined by François Courtillier, who is marketing leader for the residential market at Schneider. Hello, François.
Hello, Joanne, thank you very much. So I'm very happy and thrilled to be with you today and to be part of the innovation journey that Schneider is taking to have smarter homes and, of course, more sustainable homes. So we'll see that with you.
For everyone joining us today, we want to make sure that sustainability is not just a catchphrase and a catchword. This is something simple, doable, achievable, and action-oriented. So we are going to explore in these TED Talks, innovation talks, all these action-oriented things. François, as a start, what sustainability means for you?
Well, that's a big topic. Thanks for the question. Sustainability means for me, first of all, it's the hashtag Be Wiser. And you can see that on the booth today. And this is how we are able, with the Wiser system, to influence the way we behave, the way we take actions in order to bring a more sustainable home and to reduce the energy. Of course, as you know, you probably know that 20% of our greenhouse emission gas are coming from homes, in the world. So that's a big ocean, and everyone, each of us could say, my home, my flat, my house is just a drop in the ocean, but oceans are made of drops. So everything counts, everything needs to happen, and we can collectively all act to build this ocean and to drive to a more sustainable world.
I agree, every little step do matter, and that's what we want to do together in this booth. Now, let's drill down into some of the potential actions to make our homes more sustainable. But before we do so, can you explain what net zero means? We talk about sustainability, net zero, what's the concept?
Sure. So net zero means, let's imagine by 2030, all of the homes in the world are moving to be powered by electricity only, not fuel, not gas, anyone, only electricity. We could save up to 8 billion of tons of CO2. Around the world. Just for your information, the residential US emissions today are around 1 billion. Second step, if we move to a net zero, fully home equipped, that would represent more than 20 billion of tons of CO2 saved all over. So the impact is huge. What is net zero? So this net zero is quite of an equation. Globally, you consume, and globally, your home will be able to produce later. So you consume, so you have to act on what you consume. You have to work on better consuming, having the right eating, selecting the right loads when you did it, and not always. Okay, so you work on your power consumption, but you also have a home which is completely insulated and ready, and not for loss of energy, but you also have to have a power generation, I would say, or electricity generation, thanks to solar panel, for example. And so the net zero means that what you produce as an energy, you consume it. So in the end, zero gas emission, no carbon footprint, and in the end, of course, no bill in cost of energy.
We did a recent survey at Schneider Electric where we acknowledged that 60% of the respondents thought it's so important to have their homes become net zero into the next decade or into their lifetime. And there is a downside of it that many people don't believe it will happen. So we are here to say that it's possible, and we are here to bring the optimism. Though, it comes with kind of a high investment. Well, that's the preconception. So is this really the case? What makes a home zero, net zero?
First of all, you're right. It's, like I said, a drop of the ocean makes ocean, so it's a collective approach that we need to do. But also, we are at a turning moment today. Well, turkey moment, because most of the sources of power are moving to electricity. We are getting rid of gas, fuel, and so on. So this is the first item we need to keep in mind. The second one, that you all live together, you all live with it since more than a decade now, it's about digitization. And digitization, you know, artificial intelligence brings smartness inside. So of course, you have to combine both, and we will see in the end that the combination of more electricity, reducing the carbon footprint, and digitization, bringing artificial intelligence and inefficiency in the end, will bring all this impact of energy consumption down. Back to your point on, back to it, because you asked a question, I have to answer. Is it an investment? Yes, of course, it's an investment. We'll come back later. But anyway, we have to keep in mind that each and every one with simple actions, that potentially we'll review in the next talk, by the way, with simple actions, basics, we can actuate and we can already have an impact on our energy consumption.
Now, okay, we understand that it's possible. Can you make this turn into a reality? What are the concrete things we can do?
Hey, concrete things I've talked about already, digitization. Let's talk about smart device. You can see on the booth you have smart plugs, you have smart thermostat, you have smart heating, and all of this combined will make a smarter home and will help you to take the right decision, help you by showing you information, what you do, what you consume, where you consume and when you consume, but also it could anticipate and take into account your habits, because of course this will be not against the comfort. So it will take into account your habits and bring a little bit of artificial intelligence in order to optimize all the systems in a net zero configuration.
Okay, I understand, but what if I rent an apartment? What if I rent a house?
If you rent a house, no problem. I mean, you have some different devices that you can install when you come, and you can disinstall and reinstall when you go. For most of them, you can do it by yourself. Of course, when you have to go in the electrical panel door, could be different. But the investment, for example, of a power tag, worth definitely the investment by the saving you can have over a couple of years. So it should not be a barrier, definitely. It should not be a blocking point for people to move forward on this topic.
Interesting, and these are simple actions. Now, what are the ones which deserve bigger investments?
So, back to the big investment. I said, yes, we can have big investments, and not only simple action, of course, but it starts with all what you hear every day. It starts with, I'm going to buy an EV car, okay? So I will have to plug it, and I will be fully electrical. Another one could be installing solar panel, of course. Another one could be working on more insulation of your house, changing the windows. But also you have a big trend that we can see in Europe and all over the world, moving to heat pumps. So it's back to what I said at the beginning, simple action, but it's also making some investment to bring net zero emission because all the loads are becoming electrical. And by the way, there are a lot of incentives. So the timing is there. It's now it's going to happen. Lots of governments are bringing incentive for you to install heat pumps, for you to install EV charging station and all of that. So your infrastructure in your house can also be incentivized. So have a look at it. I think that's the right timing to move forward.
So as a wrap up, keep it simple. Make it happen. There is so many little things we can all do. And smart home is definitely one of the ways we can all connect together our homes to make them more efficient and more sustainable. In a recent survey we did, already half of the respondents told us that they really believe smart home is a way to make their bills lower and to make their home more sustainable. So it's important for all of us, and it starts at home.
It's a hello, and don't forget, every single act counts. It will have impact, global impact. So the question today is, we've been part of the problem of carbonization, and now we have the opportunity to be part of the solution. All together, one plus one, we make an ocean. And this is a fight we are in, and we think this is a good fight, and we ask you to join us in this good fight.
Thank you so much, François. Thanks a lot to the audience. We are here every day over the past 5 days. Every hour or so, we have 15-minute TED Talks-like sessions, so we call innovation talks. We are going to debate about sustainability, energy bills, energy efficiency, EV, all these trends that are really shaping the markets today and that are making our homes more efficient and more sustainable. So So thank you so much for listening. If you have any questions, feel free to join our booth, see our demos, and we are here to answer.
Green t-shirts. Thank you.